Hello guys, welcome back once again to the part 2 of Increase Your Productivity Using Q-Dir File Explorer and Manager. So in part 1, we have seen how we can download this cool software, and we have seen some of the options available in this cool software. Okay, in this part, I'm going to show you more options that we can use to help increase our productivity. Okay. We have already seen how we can add more tabs in one window and how we can close that. Okay, so I'm gonna just discuss, like, you can also use the keyboard shortcuts to open up the new tabs within the window, and then you can also use the shortcuts to close it. Okay, so to open up the new tab, you can also use Control T, and then if you want to close it, you can use Control W. And if you want to duplicate this tab, you can use Control K, okay? And again, Control W to close it down. Now let's talk about the other cool features of Q-Dir. So here we have the menu bar, and the first thing we are gonna see in the file menu is basically the duplicate window. Basically what it does, it just duplicates whatever the first instance you have here, okay? The second option is basically open Q-Dir state. Before discussing it, we have to discuss basically what is Q-Dir state, okay? So just take an example, like I am working on some project and I do have these all directories open, right? Meanwhile, I have got something new, which is basically another project, and that project uses some other directories. So what I can do here is basically I can save all that configuration, and then once I will be done with the other project that just came up, I can reload the configuration for the project that I am currently working on. And in that case, all of my directories that I have opened right now, they will be opened later as is, right? Let's take a practical example of whatever I have just explained, okay? So the first thing we are going to do here is save the configuration as Q-Dir state. So just click here on the file and then go to save current state, okay? This pop-up window will come up, and then we will just type the name of our configuration, like the test, and then I'm going to save this guy, okay? And then I will gonna change to the other directories that just arrived as a project 2. So here I have created this new project, just came up with the different sets. Okay, data set 1 here. I'm gonna change here this as well as data set 2. And here is this guy, data set 3. And here is data set 4. And then I'm gonna open up the new window as data set 5. Okay, so this is basically the whole new structure of different directories, which I am working on new project just came up folder. Okay, now I am done with whatever I'm doing with this new project, and I am about to go back to project 1, which I was working on, which was from database. So what I'm going to do here is on click file and then open Q-Dir state here, and then I will open this test Q-Dir, and you can see it just loaded up whatever I had before. So this is the cool thing that I really like. And the other options we have in the file menu are to run command prompt from here, or to run PowerShell, or the explore function. Basically, the explore function, what it does, it actually fetches all your directories in by default Windows Explorer. So let's try it out. And you can see all of them, they are opened as default Windows Explorers. You can see here, I do have 4 project 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, so you can do this if you really need it. Okay, so we are almost done with all the options here in the file menu. This is just the last one, which is the language change, if you really need to change the language. Okay, so let's talk about the options we have in the edit menu. So these are the options we have already seen, the shortcuts. The only good option here is the copy path, which basically copies the the path of your current directory if you really need it. For example, if I'm gonna do this guy here, so it's gonna copy the path. The action is successfully completed copy path. So basically what it did, it basically copied this path of your current directory. Okay, so in the view menu we have like common options. The first one is the status bar enable disable. This is the status bar here, and the second one is the full screen, and these are the default options we have in the Windows. In the favorites bar we can add these directories as our favorites and organize them. Okay, last but not least, we have the extras menu here with several options. So the first option is Q-Dir always, which is about the position of the Q-Dir. Like if I'm gonna select it as middle, if I'm gonna close this guy and then I will open it back, it will start from middle of the screen. Okay, all right, so we do have other options here. You can just play with them whatever you really like. I like the last window position. Okay, so in the extras menu we have the second option as starting as which layout. So by default it starts as a quad layout, but you can change whatever you wanna have. Okay, so the third option we have here is the list view. Like here we have save columns, full row select, show grid lines. So show grid lines is like this. It looks like Excel, so that's why I don't like this option here. So I'm just gonna disable this one. And here is, I have this full row select. If I'm gonna disable this guy, it looks like this. If I'm gonna enable it back, it will be like this. It highlights the full line. Okay, so here in the list you can also play around with the other options. There are a lot, I'm not going to discuss each and everything, but this is the option that I kind of left here, use color filters, and I will discuss it later. Okay, so this is the fourth option we have in the extras menu. This is about the tree view. You can also play around and select the best options you would like to implement on. And this is the title bar. Again, you can play around with that. And this is the address bar. And you can also play around with whatever you want to do with the address bar. And this is the color and design. This feature, I guess, I discussed already in the first part of the series. And you can select the different colors whatever you like. Like just for example, I'm gonna select the black is my color. You can see that kind of thing is messed up. I know it's kind of like a bug, so I'm just gonna minimize it and then maximize it back, and it will change the colors. This is kind of like a bug maybe, or I don't know what it is. Basically, I'm gonna change it to disable all color jokes, and then gonna do the same thing again, and then it will eventually restore to the default settings. Okay, and we have the other options like the status bar, data size, tabs, file operations, print preview, font. Font, you can change the size of the font, and then dark theme. If you are, again, if you are a lover of the dark theme, you can change this guy to dark theme, and then it's gonna restart by default, and then it will look like this. I don't like dark theme because I don't know, for some reason it didn't change the address bar. Maybe there should be some options to change it. So I'm gonna change it back to the default one, and then it's just restarted and restored the default theme. So the last thing we are gonna discuss here in extras menu is more options feature. When you click here, it's gonna open a new window called options. So here we have different tabs, and we can do exact same settings whatever we have seen in the extras menu. But the only thing that I didn't mention before, it was the colors, use color filter option. Okay, so if I'm gonna check this guy here, so now you can notice all of the files got changed with blue color. Okay, but this is what I don't want. So what I'm gonna do here is, basically we do have a list of different extensions assigned with different colors, and by default all of them they got assigned with blue. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to replace this one with the extension Verilog. Okay. And then you can see all of the text file, they are just by default black color. And then I'm going to show you, like, if I'm going to create a file with the extension V, like Verilog with the extension V. Okay. And then you can see it changed with the blue color. Okay. And then I'm going to create other files just to show you how we can assign different colors. Okay. So for example, this is going to be a ticket script with the extension TCL. And then we are also going to create a C file, C code with the extension .c, and another is the shell script with the extension sh. Okay, and then we are gonna go back to the options here, and then we are gonna add the other colors to these extensions. Okay, so click here on the add, and then new filter, it's gonna be with the extension .tcl. Okay, and then I'm gonna change the color of this TCL to maybe this one. Click okay, and then you can see we have the tickle extension changed to different color, and you can do to the rest of them, like asterisk and .c file. And then the color is gonna be green, something like that. You can change here. And then I'm gonna apply this to SH, which is the shell script. And then the color is gonna be like light purple, okay? And then what also you can do, change these settings as well. Like if I'm gonna do with tickle, I'm gonna make it bold. I can make this guy bold, or maybe this settings, you can notice the change, or underline it. You can change it to underline it. So this is super cool feature that I really like most. You can play around with all that things, all whatever the extension of files you have. You can, you know, it's just one time thing. You do it and then you keep these settings for all of your data, and then it will basically help you to recognize your files real quick. So this is how you can increase your productivity here with the Q-Dir software. So I hope you enjoyed the video. So all that tricks helped me a lot, and I hope it will help you as well to increase your productivity. Either you are a student or a working professional, I hope it will help you in your work. So, thank you so much for watching.